Good morning, everybody. Happy Monday. We have an amazing show for everybody today. What do we have, Krystal?
Indeed we do. We got Zed Jelani on. He's going to talk about the ramifications of that attack on the Capitol. We're also going to have Reverend Dr. William Barber on. He's going to be talking about minimum wage hike and also the filibuster. But we wanted to start with some new bombshell revelations about Congressman Matt Gaetz.
Yeah, that's right. The Gaetz story is just exploding in terms of the number of crazy details. Now, around the allegations themselves, there haven't necessarily been a lot of developments, but there has been quite a bit of reporting into the personal conduct of Representative Matt Gaetz. The Fox, when Fox News discovers something, they really go all in. This is their headline: Orgy, Underage Girls, Sex Games, and Extortion inside the allegations surrounding Representative Matt Gaetz. Basically, they're tracking Gaetz's like prolific sexual behavior and bragging about it for a lot of his colleagues, all the way back to the days in the House of Representatives, in terms of like games of like women they were trying to bag, in terms of bragging to each other.
Down in the State House in Florida.
Down in the State House in Florida, but also in terms of alleged, remember, this is all alleged, he denies basically all of it, around payments to prostitutes and others. And this is really where the involvement of that former close associate, who's been indicted by the feds, that seems to be where this all stemmed from.
Mm-hmm.
Because he is the person who's charged with paying underage and, you know, creating fake IDs for underage women and prostitution and all these. A very close friend of Matt Gaetz. And according to the investigators, the New York Times and many others who are going and looking into this, is that Gaetz and him were engaged in a lot of these schemes, both around like procuring women in order for them to party with down in Florida, as well as here in Washington, D.C. And you can see very easily how the charge here that he's being charged with, which again is transporting a 17-year-old girl across state lines for sex, could easily get caught up in a lifestyle in which he seems to have been engaged in this entire time.
Yeah, I mean, so in terms of his personal conduct, what is coming out more and more is like the most stereotypical, grotesque frat boy behavior.
Yeah.
Which is never acceptable, but you're talking about an almost 40-year-old man.
Yeah, and a member of Congress.
A member of Congress.
What did you think was going to happen?
Who's showing, allegedly showing off nude photos and videos on the floor of the House.
Let's put this up there.
His colleagues.
Yeah.
So that's something that's being revealed here right now. Also going back, like you were saying, to his conduct when he was in the Florida legislature. And apparently some of this had been reported out before, though I was not aware of it. There was reporting about how they had this, again, totally grotesque frat boy type behavior of some sort of sexual point system, including Harry Potter references. One woman who was a Republican, well-known Republican woman in the state, she was labeled the snitch because you basically win the game if you have sex with her.
Yeah.
So I guess part of why this story is so interesting to me is because normally in Washington, and I think in the country at large, despicable asshole behavior seems to be rewarded.
Yeah.
And these people seem to find greater and greater success. But in this particular case, it seems like not only the fact of the alleged conduct, but the fact that he's just been a not very nice person to basically everyone he's interacted with in this town.
That's the
has
funny
left
part.
Him with very few allies.
That's the funny part of that CNN story. It was like two sources with direct knowledge, a.k.a. two members of Congress, who he was flashing this stuff to, were like, all right, screw him. We're going to go on background.
We see an opening and we're going to take him down.
I found this crazy quote from his book. So he says, I arrived in D.C. as a single man after a couple of long-term relationships. I knew going in how many people had been brought down by sexual missteps in this town. So I set some rules to help myself err on the safer side. I have an active social life, and it's probably easier in the era of Trump. I'm a representative, not a monk. It is risky to date in a town where there's potentially a thin line between love and blackmail. He goes on to express bewilderment at former representatives who had to resign over sexual relationships which violated his rules. He says, once again, they rarely take away your committee assignments unless they think you're a real troublemaker. I hope mine aren't revoked when this book is published. Then he talks about D.C. is said to have the highest concentration of spies and hookers. So even if you don't think of D.C. as very tempting, you should stay on your toes here, lest you get seduced for one purpose or another. I mean, so he seems to have called it all in his book and is like, well, I set these ground rules and I'm not going to play around with hookers or any of this stuff. And at the same time, she appears to be engaged in exactly that. Well, I guess his rule didn't, he didn't violate his rules because it's happening down in Florida. And I guess maybe that's why he's transporting people here to Florida. So, and again, allegedly,
right.
To all of this, I do think it is an instructive thing about flying too close to the sun. And I also think it is very interesting to see how people on the right who love to talk about Hunter Biden, which is crazy, like don't get me wrong, and his personal life.
We're going to cover Hunter Biden in this show,
too. We're getting to Hunter. Don't worry. We're talking about that later. But who love to talk about Hunter and pass around pictures of him with his crack pipe and engage in all kinds of like crazy behavior and all of that. They're like, this is a political witch hunt. Sorry. I mean, the guy appears to have been like engaged in all sorts of degenerate behavior. And it's like, this is what happens whenever you're doing stuff like this. Yeah, you're going to get nailed with accusations about, you know, going and transporting a 17-year-old girl. Like, I have no sympathy for so many of the actors who are trying to just completely cover this stuff up. And especially when they are happy to do it. Eric Swalwell and Fang Fang or whatever her name was, the Chinese spy and Hunter. But here it's like, oh, no, you can't talk about it. Now it's a political witch hunt. It's like, get out of here.
Right. Yeah. Well, it is interesting to me, too, that Fox went so hard in that article. Just, I mean, with the headline and then they really actually go in depth on some of the allegations around his personal behavior, but also what the feds are looking into, which is both the underage, the 17-year-old girl trafficking, and also allegations of other paying for sex, potentially with of age women. But, you know, he did that interview with Tucker where he weirdly sort of tried to, like, pull Tucker into this whole thing. Said, hey, you remember, we had dinner together. And Tucker's like, I have no idea. Hey, remember, you got hit with allegations, too. Tucker was like, that was 20 years ago, and there was nothing. This person was mentally ill, and I literally never met her. I mean, the implication. And then he takes the extraordinary step of, after the interview is over, coming back on to be like, that was the weirdest interview I've ever done, and I have even more questions now. Well, Fox had kind of been hands-off on this thing for a while, and now it seems like they're starting to go in on Gaetz, especially with this article, I think, is a major example of that. And look, Fox News may have taken some hits in the Trump era, especially after he lost the election, and they weren't willing to go down the Stop the Steal rabbit hole, but Fox News still dictates a lot of what Republicans and conservatives think about things. So if they've turned on Gaetz, that's a major, major political problem for him. And at this point, remember, he had already floated just before these allegations broke, like, oh, I might leave Congress and go work at Newsmax. We covered here last week how Newsmax hasn't said anything about it. One American News Network was like, no.
Yeah.
And Fox News was like, hell no.
Yeah, we have no interest. We have no interest in hiring him. And
so part of the question here is not just, is he able to, you know, is he going to face actual charges? Is he going to be indicted? That's number one. Number two is he going to be able to keep his seat? Number three is he going to be able to continue in public life whatsoever? And so the fact that these major media outlets are turning on him that should be his allies in normal times, very bad sign for him.
Yeah, I think that's exactly right. And at the same time, we have ABC News put this up there on the screen where the feds are looking at payments from alleged payments from Representative Matt Gaetz made to women online solicitation. One of the things that was that we saw in the New York Times is that some of the women that they spoke to said they've been paid for sex. Gaetz actually paid them on Cash App. So maybe don't do that whenever you're engaged in illegal activity, which is paying people on verifiable online transactions.
This is the thing. When he first, his very first statement, he gave that statement to Axios, an interview to Jonathan Swan. And he said this thing that seemed like kind of a non sequitur about how, like, he's very generous with his partners.
Right.
And I was like, what's going on with that statement? Because no one was saying, like, it wasn't relevant to what was in the public sphere at that point. So now we know why. And some of the reporting of these, again, allegations was that he and the dude, what's his name, Joel Greenberg, were procuring these women on these sugar daddy websites, which honestly, it's a legal gray area. And look, I have actually very, you know, we probably have very different views on sex work, and I have relatively liberal views on this, but it can actually be a real legal gray area of, like, where's the line between I'm paying for your dinner, paying for you to fly around, I'm paying for you to stay at a hotel, I'm giving you a monthly allowance, where does that turn in by the legal definition to sex work? That's one of the things that will be explored here, I think.
It's going to be an interesting trial and investigation. Regardless, you can really just see the implosion here of a congressman's career, and I think it's going to be a big problem for him in the future. So there we go.
We're going to tell you what's on our radars. That's next.